the obelisk was it's kind of part of what became a sort of theme for the Egypt levels, which was we have a very small obelisk out at the front and a very large obelisk, this super gigantor obelisk here. And the idea of moving the pieces from the giant obelisk and just whacking them into the little obelisk in order to actually open the Scion room.
Yeah. When we were sort of trying to come up with a theme for Egypt, we decided early on that we wanted to make Egypt sort of themed around lots of difficult traps. So while we wanted to keep sort of the gameplay in a lot of the rooms very similar to how it was in Tomb Raider 1, we felt that we could spice up long, boring hallways with a good amount of traps, which both made them more interesting and also gave us an opportunity to challenge the player in between sort of the main rooms that they remembered from TR1. So I would say that we've done a fairly good job at making a just regular traversal down your average hallway pretty difficult. In Tomb Raider 1, Lara, sort of one of the only difficult things that she could do was make these really large jumps. And so this area was an area where Lara had to sort of leap precariously back and forth between platforms, sort of sticking out along the walls of this room. Now that our current Lara in Tomb Raider Anniversary is way sort of more nimble and attaches to ledges and hangs on a whole lot easier, we had to sort of figure out a way to make a room themed around sort of this large ascent and precarious jumping over a large drop, but still sort of keep it challenging for the player. So we sort of made a fairly more complicated room. We sort of themed around these broken sort of floors of a large chamber that had broken away, and just sort of pillars were remaining that Lara had to traverse up.
Thank you. No. No. No.